శ్రీమాన్ వెంకటనాథార్య కవితార్కికేశరి వేదాంతాచార్య వర్యో మే సన్నిధత్తాం సదాహృది. పెరుమాళ్ అపియర్స్ టు బి ఆస్కింగ్ స్వామి ఆవణాచార్య, ఆల్ దిస్ యు హవ్ బీన్ సేయింగ్ అళవందారే, థింకింగ్ దట్ యు హవ్ పర్ఫార్మ్డ్ ప్రపత్తి, హౌ డిడ్ యూ డూ అండ్ why did I establish prapatti shastra only for you, alavanda? I blessed many prapannas before you and I will in future as well. It's wrong to say it is very rare and not possible to receive the recipient of my daya other than you. The response from alavandar for perumal's question is this shlokam. Here Alavandar declares that there is none but, there is nothing but to give, grant moksham to Alavandar and no way out. And that's the verse number 51. If Alavandar responds saying that if you leave at least me after having performed Sharanagati at your feet, and thus leaving and ignoring someone in spite of him, his performance of the upayam, of course you can do that as an independent nirankusha swatantran. You are unparalleled lord and nobody is going to challenge you, but then you need to send others who have already attained moksham by performing prapatti back again to this world, because on what reason you took them, same reason you should take me, because you are satyakaman, satya sankalpan. Hence there will be none to receive your daya if I am dropped or if you miss me. It is a fact and you cannot deny it. That's the slogan. తదహం త్వదృతేన నాతవాన్ మధృతే త్వం దయనీయవాన్న చ విధి నిర్మితం ఏతమన్వయం భగవన్ పాలయమస్మజీహపః. హే భగవానే, తదహం త్వదృతే నాతవాన్ న, ఐ బికమ్ దుర్లభన్ ఫర్ యూ. యు ఆర్ ద దయనీయర్, the dayaniya, dayakaran, dayanidhi, and I have become durlaban for you. And adiyen aham todrite natavanna, I do not have any other lord, master, swami, seshi, talaivan other than you. And tvamcha madrite dayaniyavan nacha, for you also madrite, other than me, there is no recipient of your daya or the right satpatram for recipient of daya other than me. There is nobody. Vidhi nirmitam etam anvayam palayam asma jihapaha. Vidhi, this is the way thou shall go. It is your daya and it has been established that this is the way, as because of your daya. And yetam anvayam, this rakshaka rakshya bhava rupa sambandham, you are the rakshakan, I am the rakshan, and you are sharanagata vatsalan, I am sharanagatan, and palayam asma jihapaha, you should protect this sambandham, this rakshya rakshaka bhava rupa sambandham, the sharanagata sharanagata vatsala sambandham, sesha sheshi sambandham. This you should protect, you should take care. Masma jihapaha, should not let it slip away. And hence, I am the foremost among those who need to be saved and protected. Please do not let me down. And Bhagavan, you are the Bhagavan, means Agileheya Pratyanikatve Sati Kalyana Gunakaratvam. ఉభయలింగాధికరణం, అఖిలేహేయ ప్రత్యనీకం డివైడ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఇంపర్ఫెక్షన్స్ అన్ అనంత కళ్యాణ గుణగణోగ మహార్ణవం ఇన్ఫినిట్లీ మోస్ట్ ఆస్పీషియస్ attribute samasta kalyana gunanidhi, and which itself includes the daya gunam as well. So vidhi means your daya, and it is you who needs to establish that this is the way. Only because of your daya this needs to happen. Because of some punyam, some suhrut, without our knowledge, inadvertently, if we would have performed some little bit of punyam, even unknowingly, and Swami takes that as a vyajyam, excuse, lame excuse, pretext, and give us an opportunity to have a sadacharya sambandham and perform pravati. And he bless showers with his daya and intervenes in our life and interrupts in our trespasses against the sastras and is able to keep us back on track and save us and palaya. So you should protect that your daya. You are establishing such a path for us. And masma jihapaha, please do not slip it away. Here, any fruit without your granting, none can get or receive. You alone can grant. Even if it is obtained through other devatas, as declared by you in Gita. While moksha cannot be granted by anyone other than you. Moksham dadati iti mukundaha. So, none else can grant. You preserve that right for you alone and have not delegated that to anyone. You alone are my Swami and you alone are for me, nobody else. You are the Talaivan, master for me. I am the deserving one, most deserving one to receive your grace and daya. There is none else. Because if you do not bless others, they would themselves involve themselves in some other means, go to some other god, demigods, and perhaps reach you after few births later. I am not like that. I am the lowliest of the lowliest. And I have ananya gatitvam. I have no other gati other than you. I do not have any capacity at all to rise above waters and perform any other means. No bhakti yoga. And no other person to save me. I am the fittest person to be the recipient of your infinite daya. It is your wonder of all wonders that I am even having the mind to seek your grace with such pitiable plight and state and with such lowliest nature. This itself is your sankalpa, and hence it is destiny that you and I are in this stage now. You at the highest of the highest position as the Supreme Lord, and I who has realized this, who has been blessed to realize this, who understands this as a Sheshi Babam, at least now, have performed, held on to your feet, and you, it is your sankalpam. Somehow I have been blessed to receive your daya. You would not have done it without any reason, and there should be a plan by you as well. So please save me and make me the object of your daya. Do not spurn me. Do not let me down. Masma jihapaha. Hey Bhagavan. Palaya masma jihapaha. Please protect me. Please protect this vidhi. Even if you save others and ignore me or discard me, then also you are being addressed as Paramadayalu would go away. Because here is one who is also the recipient of grace, who has also performed prabhati in verse number 22, and who has been ignored and spurned. Please do not get that name and have a blemish on your name. Hence, please save me for your sake. In this verse, Swami wonderfully, Alavandar wonderfully mingles and intertwine the Swamitvam and the Vatsalyatvam very nicely reflected and depicted by Yamunacharya. And he says, I am the chief, the foremost among the people who need to be protected. And even though you say you have blessed many prapannas before you, before me, leaving and ignoring someone in spite of having performed the upayam, though you can do, you should not do, because you are satyakama, satya sankalpa. There will be none to receive your daya if I am dropped, and it is a fact. So please save me. Please do not spurn me. Do not ignore me. Who I am in a pitiable, helpless state to receive your daya. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.
Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Keshari Vedanta Acharya Varyome Sannidattam Sadahurde Namo Narayana.
Let's continue to enjoy Swami Yamanacharya's wonderful Stotra Ratnam. Today's verse is number 52. It's the wonderful, most beautiful verse, and it kind of clarifies our seemingly having doubts on prapatti and the qualifications to perform prapatti. So Perumal appears to be saying that all this you are saying that you have performed prapatti. How did you do? You described me as I am Sri Apati, and which Vaidika would not accept me as the Supreme Lord? That is my Swarupa. What was your Swarupa? What is your nature? Did you consider yourself like you are to me as Dasan, Session and devotee? Are you not devotee of someone else? In which case, how can and why should I save you? However, whichever manner does one understand and comprehend the Atma, the pursuit will change, would vary. So, Alavandar, what's your response to this? Swami appears to be responding to this question. Number 52. Vapura dishiyopi kopiva gunato saniyata tata vidaha tadayam tavapada padmayoho Ahamadyaiva maya samarpitaha. Aham, adiyen. Vapuradishu yopi kopiva. Vapuradishu. From the body, from the senses, from the mind, vapuradishu. Ya api ka api va yopi kopiva. From the body, mind and the senses. Anything, anyone. Gunato sani yata tada vidaha. Gunato asani. Gunataha. Due to my swabhavam, due to my nature, yata tada vidaha. I could have been anybody. I could have been dehatma brahmam, or I could have been something else. Whatever it could be, let it be so. Tadayam aham. Such adiyen. Such me. Such I. Tavapada padmayoho adyaiva maya samarpitaha. That adiyen, so called like that, the with the adjective which we talked about, vapuradishu yopi gopiva gunataswani yata tatas vidaha tadayam aham tavapada padmayoho. Hence, this adiyen, who has been described in the above line, has placed at your lotus feet, I have placed by me, so as a samarpanam at your lotus feet. I am aham tavapada padmayoho adyaiva maya samarpitaha. I have placed at your lotus feet now. Which means in the verse 22. So, I who is performing prabhati sharanagati due to the nature of and association with this body, mind, sense organs and their influence, and because I am equipped with according to the prakriti, according to the maya, according to the cosmic matter sambandham, whatever may be, with good atma guna or full of follies, blemishes, mistakes, whatever may be the nature, I may not be even aware of the defects in me, about the viparita jnanam in me, about the wrong jnanam in me, about the qualities, but being the one performing sharanagati, with the nature as explained above, with the lack of jnanam, with full of defects, with mind, with the senses, with all that. Adiyan, this lowliest one, with all the limitations, is offering Adiyan's Atma at your lotus feet. And that is what is mentioned as I in me, Maya Samarpitaha. So, what is the essence of this verse? Vapuradishi Yopi Gopiva. There are different kinds of arguments in Atma Vicharam. The Charvaka, some people say body itself is Atma, Dehame Atma. Though even if there is body, there are no senses, there is nothing, and hence Indriyas, sense organs are the Atma, some people say. There can be many like sense organs like eyes, ears. How can there be so many Atma in one body? So it has to be Manas. Others argue, challenge. They say, no, not even Manas. The Pranan that goes in and out is the one that makes one alive. And hence Pranan is the Atma. And some people say not even Pranan. It is Buddhi which is the Atma. There is an argument goes on and on. With all the above, how can I be aware of the actual Swarupam of the Atma? I may not even know the true nature of Atma. It's beyond body, mind and the intellect. Hence, I'm not even aware of the attributes of the Atma, the gunas of the Atma. And the gunata sani yata tada, gunata asani yata tata vidaha. Whatever may be the Atma, is it nityam, anityam, atomic, fully manifested? Is it swayam prakasham, jadam? I'm not knowledgeable on these things. After getting to know the same, only one can meditate and perform bhakti yoga after getting to know all these things. For totally surrendering at your lotus feet, to place my Atma, regardless of what it is, regardless of how it is, regardless of my understanding of it, I place the Atma at your lotus feet, with you alone as the only gati, you alone as the goal. I do not have to know what it is. I'm sure. I'm not seeking the refuge at anyone else except you. That much I know. For sure, you are the unparalleled Supreme Lord who can grant moksham and you, who can only grant moksham. You alone can grant moksham. And I'm also sure that I lack completely the qualification, utterly helpless in this state, with complete lack of jnanam on everything associated with these things. So, I have done that. Aikantika Nitya Kinkara. Aikantika Nitya, whatever may be the Atma, and whatever may be the Atma's nature, as long as this Atma is there, I would like the same to be the eternal servant of yours. I may not have the jnanam about this Atma, whether it is this, whether it is that, whether it is mind, body, intellect, sense, I don't care, I don't know. I am your servant. And your servant alone. I have offered the same completely at your feet. It does not mean at all that I have understood the nature, guna, attributes of the Atma. Vapuradishi yopi gopiva. Adiyen. Vapuradishi yopi gopiva gunata sani, gunata asani yata tata vidaha. Whatever may be that, I have offered the same unconditionally, unflinchingly at your lotus feet. Mayasama, ahama dhyaiva mayasama arpita. Adhyaiva, ippode, right now, I have placed at your lotus feet. Yo, yohamasmi sa san yaje. Veda also says, I am your eternal servant. Thus, Alavanda says, by actually and fully knowing the nature of Atma, one can perform prabhati. Or, by without knowing the nature of Atma Swarupam, also one can perform prabhati at his lotus feet. But all that one needs to know, this Atma is the eternal servant Sesha Bhutan of Sriman Narayana, and none else other than Sriman Narayana can grant moksham, and none else is the upayam and upayam, the goal and the way, the means and the destination. This is a slogan based on Tirukoshtiyu Nambi when he explained the nature of Atma being eternal servant of Sriman Narayana, alone as the Swarupa Nirupakam to Sri Ramanujacharya. This is the slokam based on which Trikoshtuna be explained to Ramanuja. So one may have illusion about this Atma, Dehan, Devata, Dehatma Brahmam, thinking that body is Atma, Swatantra Brahmam, thinking that Atma is independent, not dependent on anyone, Devatantra Brahmam, thinking that other demigods can also save this Atma and be servant to them. All these three need to be avoided. This is essential. You need not know what's the nature of Atma, but you need to know that Deham is not Atma. And you are not Swatantra. This Atma is not Swatantra. Three, you are not servant to anyone else other than Sriman Narayana. These three. Yopi, Kopiva, whatever may be, it is Deham, Atma, sense organ, whatever nature. I am offering that back to you. Thus, when performing Prabhati, even if I do not realize the true nature of Atma as Jnana Swarupi, Anu, etc., realizing its Seshatva Swarupam, I have offered the same at your lotus feet. Mere thinking that this Atma is eternal servant for Sriman Narayana alone, I know, is not granting me moksha. I need to offer the same at your lotus feet, which I had stolen from you so long, thinking that it belongs to me. So, mere thinking that I am your servant is not enough. I have to place it back, give it back to the property owner. And Parasara Bhattar, referring this verse in whatever manner, refers to Acharya Nishtai, Mukti Nishtai, etc. However, Alavanda's work, the Artha Siddhi, Atma Siddhi, establishes very clearly the Atma Swarupam. And it's not that he was not aware of this Atma Swarupam. He is only saying on our behalf and about our disqualification or lack of qualifications. So that's what Swami refers to in this verse. So, Alavandar Gunata Swani Yata Sada Vidaha. So, some people say in Mula Prakriti, the middle part is Jiva Varga. And if it desires, it can belong to, it can unite with Brahma. Yadava Prakashar said, in Moksha Dasai, it is along with Brahma. And Bhaskara Paksham says, Abhedam with Paramatma is the nature of Jivatma. And Bedam is Kalpana, Bhaskara Paksham. So there are very many, and once you realize, you should have Sastra Upadesham, and you should have Acharya Upadesham. Through Acharya, you will get the Jnanam. And once you realize that you are the Brahman, you become the Brahman, says Shankara. So, Jivan, so there are very, Jivan and Ishwaran are different. And in Yoga Sastram, with Yama Niyamam, once if a person has Upasanam, he gets Moksham. And however, in Moksham, Ishwaran and Jivan, we have no relationship and no connection. That is Patanjali Muni says. So, very many interpretations, very many confusions, but all pramanams are collected, all pramanams are analyzed with no conflict or violation of any pramanams, any sastric injunctions, Veda Vedantams. Our Purvacharyas have said, Nayam Devo Namartyo Vana Tiryak Stavaropiva Jnanananda Mayastvatma Sheshohi Paramatmanaha. The way honey bee picks up the honey from various flowers and gives the essence, our Acharyas have analyzed all these works, and they have given the essence as the Sara Jnana. Even Sri Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, in the second chapter, 46th verse, he says, Yavan artha udapane sarvata sampluttodake tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanasya vijanataha. Yavan artha udapane sarvata sampluttodake tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanasya vijanataha. Yavanartha, however much water is required for a thirsty person, in a tank full of water on all sides, similarly, only that much use is there for the truly wise Brahmana. in all Vedas. All that matters which are taught in the Vedas need not be followed by all persons. There is a pond full of water, pond, reservoir. Water can be used for several purposes, for drinking, for bathing, for washing, for cleaning, so many things. But a thirsty person will only drink as much he wants, which will quench his thirst. That's all. Similarly, a jnani, a wise man, intellect, who wants to attain moksha, will pick up the right stuff from the Vedas, only what is relevant for attaining moksha or salvation. He need not follow the other teachings or get confused and deluded, which relate to attaining swargam or other worldly desires, says Krishna. So, tat ayam aham tavapada padmayo, such me, with lack of qualifications or with confusions, have placed at your lotus feet. Maya, maya, vichitra deham asmi, vichitra deha sampatti ishwaraya niveditum, purvameva krita brahman, hastapadati samyuta, Sri Vishnu Tattvam says, this Karana Kalevaram, this body, is there given by Emperuman. It is required to place our Atma back to his lotus feet, says Vishnu Tattvam. Adhyaiva, this chanam, this fraction of a moment. We have to do a good karyam right now and then. Nandre seiga, nandrum indre seiga, indrum inne seiga. We have to immediately do then and there when we think of good deeds to be performed. So, otherwise, because of prakriti sambandham, there may be interruptions, interventions, change of mind, all that would come. So, adhyaiva maya samarpita, I place my soul right now, atma, at the lotus feet of yours. So, and we should perform ala, and we should give along with our knowing that I and my chetana chetanam are all empiriman sesha bhutam. With that thinking, we should perform. We should offer back. So, even Upari Charavasu, the king, in Shanti Parvam, he says, Atma Rajyam Dhanam Mitram Kalatram Vahananicha Yetad Bhagavate Sarvam Iti Tat Prakshitam Sada. Swami Desikan takes this and says, even he says, the king says, Atma Rajyam Dhanam Mitram Kalatram Vahananicha. Everything I perform, it belongs to Bhagavan. All that belongs to me actually belongs to him, including myself, says the king. Emperuman is the Swami. We are his property, his body. And hence, we should think that we are his dasan, Sri Hari as the Swami. Swatvam atmani sanjatam, swamitvam brahmanisthitam, upayoresha sambandho na parobi mato mama, svo jivanecha yadite swasattayam sprihayati. Atma dasyam hare swasvamyam swabhavam sadasmara. Sri Vishnu Tattva Vachanam. We should, this Sri Hari is the Swami, I as the Dasan. We should always utter smarikanam. Always think, Dasoham Vasudevasya Devadevasya Shanginaha Sankachakra Gadapane Trailokyasyaika Chakshushaha, says Narada to Pundarika. Swami Desikan refers this Vapuradishi Yopi Gopiva in Sangha Pravadana Adhigaram in Srimat Rakasya Trayasaram beautifully. He says, Vapuradishi Yopi Gopiva Ahamadyaiva Maya Samarpita. What's the Tatparyam? It's like a person who is able to have a Raja Mudra. He has got a stamp, Raja Mudra coin, which will facilitate him to get some good gift from Raja, good acceptance, recognition from Raja. That coin is covered by a silk cloth which has been handed over by his ancestors to him. He has kept it very, very safely in a locker. Suddenly he realized that I have that. And my grandfather told me that take care of this of the silk cloth which I have given you. So he has the silk cloth in which something is there. He does not know what it is. As long as you have the silk cloth, that is enough. Even if it is torn, that color, even if the color has faded, that silk cloth with its content inside, even if that guy doesn't know what is inside, as long as he knows that this silk cloth will facilitate him to get recognition, reward from the king, that's enough. The king, the moment he sees that silk cloth, he would know that, oh, this is mine and I need to give him the right thing to this guy. Similarly, Perumal knows exactly what is inside. Even if you do not know what is the Atma, what's this quality? Swami Desikan explains this so beautifully. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.
Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Kesari Vedanta Acharya Varyome Sannidhattam Sadahrithi. So, Alavandar said, I am offering myself at your feet. So the Lord appears to be asking, you have been serving and praying to others, all these births, so many births, and you have been considering yourself as completely independent, not being a servant to anyone, Swatantra. Now, why are you asking for eternal service to me alone, discarding your Swatantriyam, your independence? And after doing this, if you again get back to some other servitude to others or Swatantriyam, what to do? Because you have been having that thought so many births. So you are saying Maya, me, mine, all those words. So Alavandar responds, whatever I did, whatever did I say, consider. That's not what was intended by me when I mentioned Maya and offered myself at your feet. So the sloka comes out, number 53.
Mamanata yadastiyosmyaham sakalam taddi tavaiva madhava niyataswam iti prabuddhadihi. अथवा किम नु समर्पयामिते नाथा माधवा द चीफ ऑफ एवरीवन ओ नाथा माधवा द श्री ऑफ पति श्रीमन नारायण द वन हु इज विद पेरियपिराटी महालक्ष्मी मम यद अस्ति अहम या अस्मि इज देयर एनीथिंग विच इज माइन माय ऑब्जेक्ट. Is there anything, me, who am I, what does belong to me? They all belong to Sri Apati, Sriman Narayana. Verily, they are your own property, always, have always been, already. O Madhava, Sri Apati, with such clear jnanam that it is all your property, what is it that I can offer you when I have the clear jnanam? So, we have to, only that which we yearn in a proper manner, we can offer. Sva, 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 svatva, nivritti, purvaka, paraswatva, padanam, vitaranam. The way that we yearn in a rightful manner and then we can offer to others. When it is already belongs to you, how is it possible for me to offer mine and my soul, my property to you? What would I offer you? I and my Achit and Chetana Vastus, all of them are eternally your property. They are owned by you and Sri Madhava. Having known and been enriched with that jnanam, there is no chance of myself considering me as the Swatantra and offering something as it belongs to me, as if it belongs to me, as if it is new. How and why did I do is,
I made myself as your servant, or I reoriented myself as your servant. In the lines of Swatmanam Mayanikshipet, as instructed by you. So that is why I offered myself to you. So Adiyen, this Adiyen, this me, your eternal servant, already belongs to you. And I'm your Atma, and you own me and my achetanas, whatever that belongs to me, the body, all already are your property. And Swami Nammalvar also says the same thing. Yanum niye, yen udaimayum niye, in Thiruvaimozhi 2.9. Yane yenne ariyagilade, yane yendanade yennirindhen, yane ni yen udaimayum niye, vane yetum em vanavarere. So he said, I had lost, Nammalvar says, yane yenne ariyagilade, I had lost Emperuman so many births, so many columns. It's not because of him, it's because of myself. I had accrued vinasham by thinking, by having some other knowledge, some other jnanam about some other things, and never realized that I belong to him as his eternal servant. And that is my vinasham. Now that I have realized myself, now so far I have been thinking that his deham itself is Atma. Then I thought that the Atma is Swatantran, like the prince who has been enjoying the company with the hunters without knowing its princely origin. I was with the hunters, enjoying being a part of the hunters. So now, then after knowing that deham itself is Atma, then I was thinking Ishwaroham. I myself am the Ishwaran, and I thought everything belongs to me. Now, and I never even felt to pity on myself for having such a thought, and I was proud of having that wrong viparita jnanam. I was arrogant. Now, the answer is yane ni yen udamayum niye. Yane yandanade yandirinde. I was thinking all along that me and mine belong to me and mine always. Now, it all belongs to you. And that is why, same thing, Alavanda says, Ya Asmi Aham. This Ya Asmi Aham is considered in this verse as the very essence of pranavam. And this pranavam, the first word A is Sarvarakshakan, Emperuman is referred to, and the Pirati is referred to. Finally, the Makaram, Jivatma Rupam is referred to. And thus it is, Swami explains that the Chandasatvat Padontanvepi Makarasya Mano Dhatoho Iti Nakaro Na. So Sri Pillaipakkam Azhagiya Singhar had blessed us with a Makara Rakshay Grantham, and Swami has taken from that, and he explains so beautifully. And Acharya and Sri Vatsangachar Swami has explained this, taking this Makara Rakshay, and he says Adyam Tu Trayacharam Brahma Trayi Yatra Pratishtita. So Manu Vakyam also mentions the same. So the one, even Swami Desikan mentions this in Nyasa Dasakam. First he recites Aham Madrakshana Bharat Madrakshana Palam Tata Na Mama Sripate Reve Iti Atmanam Nikshipet Buddha. Then he says Swamin Swasesham Swavasam Swabharatvena Nirbharam Swadatta Swadiya Swartam Swasmin Yasyati Mam Swayam. The prefix Swa appears 9 times in Slokam 3. which conveys this idea. Each time referring to Bhagavan being the owner of everything we do, including the actions and their benefits. One who is doing prapatti should realize that Bhagavan is our Lord. And whatever knowledge that we have, whatever that we do, whatever effects they have, whatever benefits they result in, these are all Perumal's acts and everything belongs to him. This is called Sattvika Tyagam. This is necessary and essential concept of any dharma towards the attainment of moksha. It consists of three parts. Kartrutva Tyagam, Mamata Tyagam, Palatyagam. We should realize that Bhagavan uses us as the means to do things. And it's not we who perform the prapatti by ourselves. It's Kartrutva Tyagam. We should realize that the benefits accruing from our acts and not the result of our acts, and it is that of Bhagavan. This is called Mamata Tyagam. And we should always dedicate the benefit, the palan, the fruits of any of our action also to Bhagavan and not look at the benefits as belonging to us. This is called Palatyagam. So the word prefix Swa appears 9 times in slokam, which conveys the idea, each time referring to Bhagavan being the owner of everything we do, including the actions and their benefits. So it does not befit to infer that Alavandar cancelled his Sharanagati which he had done in the previous verses. Acharyans of such caliber would not negate or undo what they did. This slokam is nothing but a sequel to the first slokam, the 52nd, in terms of the above Sattvika Tyagam and Kartrutva Tyagam. So the previous verse, Swami Desikaya explains this verse in Sangha Prabhadana Adhigaram in Srimad Rahasya Trayasaram. Mamanata Yadasti Slokam is about the samarpanam and Swarupadi Vivekam Andrike Samarpika Pattalum Tanudaya Dravyatai ராஜாவுக்கு உபகாரமாக கொடுப்பாரை போலே என்னது என்கிற அபிமானத்தோடே சமர்ப்பிக்கில் ஆத்மாபகார சௌரியம் அடியற்றதாகாது எங்கைக்காக அத்தனை. ஸோ சுவாமி சேஸ் திஸ் வென் வி கோ டு சி கோ அண்ட் சி த கிங் வி கிவ் எ ஸ்மால் உபகாரம். ஸோ வி கிவ் சம் திரவியம் விச் பிலாங்ஸ் டு அஸ் as a token. Similarly, this has been offered. Sastra choditamai tam anushtitta samarpanattai agyakrityam akkiyapadi andri. It doesn't negate the sharanagati which he had performed. So, na mama endru swasambandham arukkaye ahamashi tavaivasmihi baraha barasamarpana pradhanamana sastratratil saram. So, this is Barasamarpana Pradhana Sastrartham. This is the essence. So this Vapuradishu Slokam is only to perform, to offer, to place the soul at his lotus feet. And now he says, whose soul after all it is? It's already yours. I have just realized and it is Pranava Vivaranam. I had realized that it is belong to you already. And it is in accordance with the Sastram I had performed to place, to return the property which originally belonged to Perumal. And I have placed it. And it already belongs to you. And I have realized that. Swami explains this in Srimad Rahasyatraya Saram very clearly. So Swami also explains this, that this slokam, Mamanata Yadasti Me, this slokam is Mamanata Yadasti Yosmyaham Sakalam Tanti Tavaiva Madhava Niyataswam Yiti Prabuddhati Athavakim Samarpayamite. Is Swami explains this in Mula Mantra Adhigaram as well, saying that this is Pranava Vivaranam, the The secret or the ragasyam enshrined in the pranavam is this, in this slokam. So the I and mine originally belong to you. What is it that I can offer back to you? I have just realized that it originally belongs to you, and hence I had returned my soul at your lotus feet. And it's not as if I am giving you. That's what Swami explains. We will continue with the next verse next week. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Keshari Vedantacharya Varyome Sannidhattam Sadahruti. Will continue to enjoy Swami Yamanacharya's Stotra Ratnam. Today's verse is verse number 54. Till now, the Sharanagati that was performed was described and explained by Alavandar. His disqualifications are the qualifications to perform Sharanagati, namely the Akinchanya, the helplessness, and his no other refuge other than Lord Sriyapati Sriman Narayanan, Ananya Gatitvam, the nature of his Sharanagati. And then of course the Satvigatyagam, Kartrutvatyagam and Palatyagam were all explained in the earlier verses. And now Swami, after realizing that he has to spend some more time here before of course he would attain Paramapadam, he pleads for Kaikarya Sri. He pleads for intense, uninterrupted devotion, bhakti, not as the means, but as an enjoyment, but as an uninterrupted bhakti to arise in him, so that to prevent him from becoming the slave for the sense organs, and prays for such intense devotion at the feet of the Lord. Absolutely applicable to me. So Swami exactly knows that Madhava Kannan would be reciting this, and I have to compose this verse for him. So that's the one which is 54th verse. Avabhoti thavan imam yatha mayi nityam bhavadiyatam swayam kripayaivam ananya bhogyatam Bhagavan Bhakti Mapi Prayachame. So Avabhodhi Tavan. Avabhodhi Tavan. Imam Yata. Mayi Nityam Bhavadi Yatam Swayam. Avabhodhi Tavan. I have been blessed to be able to realize that Bhagavan, hey Bhagavan, Jnana Bala Aishwarya Virya Sakti Tejas, all these six attributes are in you, and hence you are called as Bhagavan. Nityam imam bhavadiyatam. Nityam, eternally, imam, this, bhavadiyatam. I have been your Sesha Bhutan. I have been your Sesha Bhutan eternally, being a servant for you. And that Yata avabodhitavan. Now I have been blessed to realize that I have been your eternal servant for time immemorial. But today only I am able to realize that you have awakened me because of your enormous compassion, because you are such a nirdosha guna nidhi, the wealth and repository of almost all samasta kalyana guna nidhi, most auspicious attributes. And so you have blessed me like that. Similarly, please, kripayaivam ananya bhogyatam bhagavan bhaktim api prayachame. Again Bhagavan, hey Bhagavan, please, kripayaivam, with your divya karunai, with your karunai, karuna, you are karuna murti, swayam, you alone on your own accord, Yevam, thus, Ananya Bhogyatam, with no other desire, with no other focus, and it should be completely purest and intense devotion. Bhaktim api me prayacha. Please bless me with complete devotion and more enjoyment forever and ever at your lotus feet, and to enjoy you alone in this world. Beautiful. What a wonderful plea. And that's what he has asked for, which is exactly same as what Nammalvar has mentioned in 1.6. He says, Vinnular Perumarka Adimai Seivarayum Sherum Aim Pulan Ivai Mannul Ennai Petral Enchayamatru Neeyum Vittal. Swami says, even the devatas are not able to focus, even the rishis are not able to focus, they are pulled by the sense organs. When so, please remove. How can I overcome such powerful sense organs? When that's being the case, they are not able to even churn the mantra ocean. You had to do that. You please remove these obstacles and facilitate me to concentrate on your Divya Mangala Vigraham, so that these sense organs are so devastating that they can destroy the continuity of a kulam, and dangerously sin-filled, it throws one into a complete chaos, and they drag you down. Like when you look at the Facebook, you just go down and down and down. You keep looking at it and it simply drains you to the bottom most. Similarly, this is what happens. So, although I get immersed in your Kalyana Gunas and exclaimed my Paranjyoti, I find myself getting caught again and again in the Prakriti. So, please bless me, Nammalvar says. So, similarly, here Swami Alavandar pleads for that, and he says, Jiva, all the Jivatmas eternally are inseparably servant for Perumal, and hence you should bless me, which I have been able to realize now due to Sadacharya Sambandham, and hence I have realized my Sheshatvam. You have blessed me like that with such a Karunyam. Now, in as much as you have sent a Sadacharyan to me to make me realize about my eternal Seshatvam, now you should bless me again the Paramabhogyam, the Bhakti at your lotus feet. Please Anugraham, please bless me with that Anugraham. Parabhakti, Paragnana, Paramabhakti, that is what Swami asked, not Upaya Bhakti. Upayam is finished, now enjoyment. So Swami Yamanacharya also refers to in Sharanagati Gadyam, Purushasya Parapartha Bhaktya Labhyastvananyaya Bhaktyastvananyaya Shakya Mad Bhaktim Labhate Param Iti Shloka Trayoditam Mam Kurushva. These three slokams, one is Purushasya Parapartha Bhaktya Labhyastvananyaya. This slokam comes in Bhagavad Gita 8.22, Purushasya Parapartha Bhaktya Labhyastvananyaya. Yeah, with that Paramapurushan, with no other means, only by Bhakti, he can be captured, he can be captivated. So that is first, Bhakti. Then, Jnanam. With that, the Jnanam, Paragnanam comes. And that is Bhaktya Stvananyaya Shakya Ahamevam Vidorjuna Jnatum Drashtum Cha Tatvena Praveshtum Cha Parantapa. This is 11.54. Here Swami says Bhaktya Stvananyaya Shakya, without Bhakti on any other thing, on others, then only you will be able to see me, know me, and enter into me, says Krishna. So, Bhaktya Stvananyaya Shakya, you will be able to realize me, know me, see me, and enter into me only by Bhakti, nothing else. Mad Bhaktim Labhate Param, which is again in 18.54, Swami Krishna says, Mad Bhaktin Labate Para. Here he says, Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Nacho. And it's Parabhakti, Paragnana, Paramabhakti. Even Priyavachan Pillai refers to these three slokams when he talks about this. So, Avabodhitavan. I was not knowing of anything earlier. Now, you have made me with Jivatma Paramatma Jnanam. Our relations, unnod uravel namakkingu olikka oliyadu. This I am able to know, realize only because of your karuna. And now, with all that, now please bless me with the complete bhakti. Now, there is a question. We should never ask after Prabhati. We should not ask Emperuman anything. Now, Swami Aravandar, how can he ask for bhakti? How can he ask for intense bhakti? How can he ask for more bhakti? Is it not wrong to ask Perumal for something after Prabhati? The answer is yes, we should not ask Perumal. And what we should not ask after Prabhati is that we should not ask for annam, panam, dhanam, vastram, ayurogyam, aspadam. Apadhyapina yacheta pujaka purushottamam. This comes, there is a vachanam for based on this, which is Swami Desikan refers to this in this slokam, and he takes this vachanam and says annam, food, panam, water, dhanam, wealth, vastram, clothing, ayurarogyam, long life, then arogyam, health, then aspadam, house, all that. Apadhyapina yacheta, even during dangerous situation, even during calamity, even during tragic circumstances, one should never ask Purushottaman for these things. Very clear. And now, same Swami writes that in Samhitai, it says, we should not ask Kshudram, Alpam, we should not ask. Tatpada Bhakti Jnanabhyam, Palam Anyat Kadachana, Na Yachet Pranato Vishnum, Yachanat Nashyati Dhruvam. This comes in Samhita. Means, at Emperuman's lotus feet, we should ask for Bhakti, we should ask for Tattva Jnanam. Other than that, we should not ask for anything which is transitory, which is diminishing, which is dying, which has got no permanence. So, other than jnanam and bhakti, tattva jnanam and bhakti, nothing else should be sought to Perumal's lotus feet. Hence, there is nothing wrong in yachakam to Perumal for atma swarupam. Nothing wrong. Even Prahlada Alvan asked that, however much the other people are having attachment and desire for their sensual pursuits and worldly pleasures, you please add all those desires for their sensual pursuits and worldly pleasures. Give me that much desire for me, for on bhakti towards your lotus feet, says Prahlada. So, ya priti ravi vekhanam Vishayeshwa Napayini Twam Anusmarataha Same Hridayat Mapa Sarpatu. Vishnu Puranam 1.20.19. Here Prahlada Alvan asks Sri Nrasimha same thing. Ya Priti Ravivekanam Vishayeshwa Napayini Twam Anusmarataha Same Hridayat Mapa Sarpatu. So that's why Bhakti Astaranya Sakya Bhat Bhakti Labadevara Purushas of Parapartha Bhaktya Labhya Astaranya. So, this is the way it should be asked. Even Swami Desikan writes that even if you ask Perumal, please bless me with evil intentions, please bless me with wrong mind. If you ask Perumal, Paramakarunika Bhagavan would never ever give us what we ask for if it is not going to do good to us. Yachitopi sada bhaktaihi nahitam karayet harihi balam agnav yat patantam tu mata kimna nivarayet. Vishnu Dharmam says, even if you go and beg him that please give me only the evil mind, please give me the cunning nature so that I destroy the other person. Even if you ask, Perumal would not give what is not hitam for Jivatma. It is like the mother who would rush to prevent the child falling into the fire, falling into the trap, falling from the into a pit. How she rushes to rescue. Similarly, Perumal would always be ready to stop us, prevent us from entering into the wrong track. That is why he sends such wonderful Bhagavata Goshti, Sadacharya Sambandham, to put us back on track. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline, Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Adiye Namo Narayana Dasan.